Why is this the biggest game in the world? It's still an enigma, but it is.
You don't even need a bed. You sleep anywhere. You slept a few times on the pitch in Paris.
I did a few mistakes. I try by myself to resolve the problem. I think you cannot do it by yourself. No. You know, you need people.
So it's good to talk.
You need people. It's good to talk. It's good to share.
As an owner, I want to help my team, Inter Miami, be the best they possibly can. Together with the teams at AIA and Spurs, we're looking at nutrition, mental health and sleep to see how they impact player performance.
You know, I think the club and the facility push me another level.
Yeah, it's all designed to inspire the footballers. Yeah. If you want to protect yourself from injury, to kind of make improvements in terms of individual parts of your game, to speed or power, you need to do a lot of work in the gym.
I think the most important, of course, is on the pitch, the talent, but today we need to know that's not enough. We need to take care about our body and about the food, and of course, sleep well is very important.
I've never seen anyone sleep as much as this man, by the way. The moment we got on the bus, the plane, the hotel, the restaurant, everywhere he'd sleep. It's important to sleep.
Very important.
That extra 1 hour. We're all looking for 1 hour more. To have an environment like this is incredible for players.
When I go to the training, you know, I want to go with fresh mind, fresh body.
One of the things you can do is go to bed at the same time each night. And something as simple as that can kind of have you in a good rhythm. Other little things, like you're not using your screens, your phones in the last half an hour before bed. So the mattresses and pillows are very important in sleep to have something. It doesn't have to be something expensive, but it has to be something that you find comfortable.
Sure.
Yep.
Because I like it.
All the players have the same mattress at home and here. So when they're here, it's a consistent bed.
It's like you feel like a home.
Yeah.
Just talk about sort of the importance of a healthy lifestyle and how you've had to change as you've gone through the years.
I suppose it's just the way the game's evolving now. It's becoming so intense. It's important you stay on top of your health. We've got two nutritionists that come in and help with our diet, give us ideas on what to eat, you know, test our body fats.
What have you learned in terms of self-discipline? You're still going to have mates, the temptation to go out.
You know, some of our friends aren't on the same wavelength, so you just have to be honest with yourself and dedicated and disciplined and just tell them no. And if they're good friends, they'll understand.
As a manager, how do you deal with the mental side of bringing these young players onto a stage like this? Do you know when a player's not ready?
I try to know. Yeah. I think sometimes you have to delay a little bit, but when they go absolutely ready. I give you my seat.
Thank you.
Because I'm never there. I think it's more difficult to cope with the social pressure than the football pressure.
Yeah, that's the toughest part for
that's
young players.
That's the toughest part. If you feel pressure to be here, you don't belong
you
here.
Belong.
If you feel pressure because you want to be a normal kid with 20, 25 years old and the world doesn't let you, that is a different thing. And in academies, I think they focus a lot on this part and help them to cope what is waiting for them outside.
Yeah. We're very lucky now to be in an era where it's acceptable to talk about struggles and about different things that
Absolutely.
You're going through, and it's not a
weakness
anymore.
Weakness.
No. Boss, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.